Hi loves, welcome to my channel. Thank you all so much for being here. I know, it has been quite some time since I posted a video. I really appreciate everybody that checked up on me during my hiatus from YouTube. I am well, so thank you for asking about my well-being. I really appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. And yeah, we'll talk about why I took such a long break from YouTube at the end of the video. But for now, let's just relax and enjoy some relaxing makeup. If you are new here, thank you so much. Welcome. This is a positive space. We have fun. It's pretty chill and we just talk about makeup. So for this look, we're going to be recreating this beautiful sunset. This look was inspired by summer, laying out by the beach, watching the sunset over the ocean, that beautiful reflection during magic hour. So if you're into bright, bold, colorful looks or just enjoying makeup artistry, then keep on watching and we will get into how this look was created. So let's get started. As always, I'm going to start by priming my eyes with my LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Fawn. I'm going to be blending that out with an e.l.f. concealer brush, making sure to take that concealer all the way up to my brow bone so that it blends in seamlessly with the concealer that I also use to clean up my brows. To start, I'm going to be going out with the Warrior 2 palette by Juvia's Place. I'm going to be picking up the black shade, that is the Shawada color, on a Morphe M405 brush. I'm creating a nice rounded shape going from the inner third of my eye to the outer third of my eye. You'll notice that I am not going directly to the far corners of my eyelid. I'm actually creating a bit of an illusion where my eye shape is a little bit smaller than it actually is, and this is going to come into play later. So all I'm doing is pecking on that color and that shape and just pushing it into the skin. I'm not doing any blending at this time because our only goal is to get that black shade on our lids. I'm then going to go into the Festival palette by Juvia's Place, and I'm going to pick up this vibrant orange color, Ofala, on a Morphe M222 brush, and I'm going to place that color directly above the black shade that we just laid down, overlapping just a little bit. And I'm also going to create a nice rounded shape with this color as well, going from the inner third of my eye to the outer third, and you'll notice that this is allowing me to go out a little bit further, and it's also widening my eye shape in the process. Before we start blending, I'm gonna go back in with that black shade and just really define and make that color pop a little bit more. Now I'm gonna start blending between both colors. So I'm gonna pick up my Morphe M506 brush and the Ofala color. I'm gonna start blending between the black and the orange shade. I'm gonna be doing small circular motions as well as small windshield wiper motions. I'm not making any grand gestures here. I'm really taking my time and really just kind of buffing where both colors meet so we get a nice transition. It's important to take your time, really work that color, stay precise, stay in the region that you want to blend, and that's what's really going to give you that beautiful gradient that we all love to see, and it's what's going to make everything feel really seamless. You're not going to know where one color really starts and where another ends. Next, I'm going to be going back into the Warrior 2 by Juvia's Place, and I'm going to be picking up the Zama color. This is a beautifully rich terracotta color, and I'm going to be using that to blend out the tops of this eye look. So what I want to do is blend out that orange color, that really vibrant orange color, so that it blends in seamlessly with my skin. I'm going to be doing this using another Morphe M506 brush. This is one of my all-time favorite brushes for blending. It really just kind of blows everything out, and it's still a really precise brush. So what you're getting is the benefit of really getting your colors blended out but not making them go all over the place. So I really love this brush for blending between colors, for blending into the skin. It's one of my top brushes. I highly recommend it. I probably have about 10 of the Morphe M506 brushes because they really are top notch. Next, we're going to be going in with that black shade, and we're going to be just redefining our crease a little bit more, making it a little bit darker, giving it more of a bit of a moody vibe. And at the same time, I'm going to be winging out my eye shape a little bit. I'm going to be dragging that black color ever so lightly. This is key. You only want the slightest amount of black shadow on your brush, and I'm just dragging that color out towards the tail of my brow. That's going to make our eye shape just look more lifted. We're going to look more awake. So even though we started out with a rounded shape, we are going to be creating a little bit more depth and a little bit more interest by winging it out in the outer third of the eye. Now it's time for us to carve out our lid. I'm going to be using that same LA Girl Pro Conceal that we used to prime our lids, and I'm just going in with a super, super thin flat brush and carving out my lid region. When you see me kind of looking up and down, that's because I'm trying to get the concealer to transfer to where my eyes kind of naturally want to be creased. And once I have that transfer, I'm just going to follow along that line, keeping in mind the shape that we want for our lid. Next, I'm going to be going in with the Slush palette from September Rose Cosmetics. I'm going to be picking picking up this vibrant yellow color called banana on a flat brush, and I'm going to be placing that directly in the center of my lid where I place the concealer, staying really close to the lash line and then just building up that color. I'm not doing any blending whatsoever. I'm just packing up the color to be as opaque as possible, and I'm starting small, but I'm slowly widening the area that I'm covering with that yellow shade. Using another flat brush, I'm going to pick up the orange color called Orange Soda. It's a really vibrant orange color that leans a little bit more of like a pastel vibe, and I'm going to place that on the lid above the yellow shade, making sure that it overlaps just a little bit. And again, I'm not doing any blending currently. I'm just making sure to place the color on the lid so that it's really vibrant and really rich and really opaque. And here you'll see me just going back and forth with the yellow and the orange from that September Rose palette. Again, I just want to make sure that the color is showing up as best as possible. So going back and forth to really pack it until I get the color payoff that I'm really looking for. I'm now going to start blending between both colors. I'm going to be using yet another Morphe M506 brush, picking up a bit of that orange color and then just blending between the yellow and the orange color. You're going to see me go back and forth between the flat brush and the yellow shade, the Morphe M506 brush and the orange shade. Again, what we're going for is just a nice seamless transition between both colors. So use whatever is at your disposal. Use whatever feels right in the moment. I think the more that you play with makeup and the more that you create these eye looks, you kind of get a sense of what's going to fit best for whatever it is that you want, and there really aren't any rules. At some point you're going to see me use my finger for some of these shadows, and that's perfectly okay. So use what you have on hand. You don't need these specific brushes. Anything that's similar will do the trick. I'm then going to go back to the Festival palette from Juvia's Place. I'm going to be using that vibrant orange color on a Morphe E19 brush, and I'm going to be placing this color at the base of my cut crease, and that's just going to give us a little bit more depth, a little bit more dimension. It's going to give us the richness of that warm sunset, but it's just going to make everything pop a little bit more, and it's going to be vibrant. And then I'm just going to lightly blend it out using very small circular motions and very small windshield wiper motions so that it blends into the lighter orange as well. Here you're going to see me using my finger to pick up that yellow shade and just packing it onto the lid. That's just going to give us a lot more color payoff. It's going to give us that pop that we're looking for right in the center of the lid. And as you can see, it makes everything just look super vibrant without losing any of the fun blending and sort of that beautiful gradient that we've created so far. Next, I'm going in with this NYX white eyeliner, and I'm just going to place that in my crease, but only going about halfway through. Next, I'm going to be going in with the NYX Glitter Primer and a super small detail brush. This one is from a nail art kit along the outer third of my eye in a really exaggerated crescent moon shape. And then I'm going to top it off with a gold glitter. Any gold glitter you have should work. This one happens to be from Shop Miss A, and it's just going to give us that shimmer vibe. Like, as I said, we're trying to recreate this beautiful sunset on a warm day when the sun is meeting the ocean, and it kind of has this really sort of glimmery effect. So I'm just going to keep building on that shape. Next, I'm going to be going in with the Morphe E19 brush, and I'm going to be picking up the Jamada shade from that same Warrior 2 by Juvia's Place. And I'm going to be placing this color where that glitter crescent moon meets the rest of the lid. This is just going to create a little bit more contrast, add a bit of dimension, and it's really going to make that glitter pop against the rest of the lid colors. I'm then going to be adding some glitter to the base of that eyeshadow look right on the lid in the center. I'm then going to take my finger and place more of that yellow shade over the glitter so that that shimmering color really seems to be coming from underneath and so that it's not overpowering. Moving on to the lower lash line, I'm going to be grabbing a Morphe M326 brush in that same black shade, and I'm going to be placing that below my lashes, and I'm going to be stopping at about halfway on the bottom lash line. I'm then going to go in with the Morphe E17 brush and the Zama color and just really blend and blow out that black shade. Again, I'm making sure to connect this color to the colors that are on the lid as well. So I'm going to be dragging that black up to the outer third of my eye so that it connects with the colors that we use on our lids as well. And I'm just using that beautiful terracotta color to really blow out that black shade to make it not so harsh. And I'm also dragging this into the inner third of my eye. I'm going to add some mascara to my top and bottom lashes, and then I'm going to place some false. These are the Coco Lashes in the Queen Bee Cell. To highlight my inner eye corner, I'm going to be going in with this beautiful kind of pale gold color. It's called Odogwu, and it's also from the Festival by Juvia's. And I'm also making sure to drag this color down to my lower lash line as well. And that pretty much completes the eye look. I did try on some more dramatic lashes, but I think I like the softer lashes instead. But you do you. You choose whatever lashes you think suit this look best. To finish up my face, I'm going to be going in with the CoverGirl Queen Ebony Bronzer on a fluffy brush from e.l.f. I'm going to be placing that along my cheekbones, the perimeter of my face, along my jawline as well. I'm going to be highlighting my face using that Adogwu color from the Festival by Juvia's. This is a really beautiful kind of pale gold that I think really works for some reason. Using a small tapered brush from e.l.f., I'm just going to be placing that along the tops of my cheekbones, along my temples, my chin, as well as my forehead. I'm also going to use that same color and a small brush to highlight on the bridge of my nose and the tip of my nose as well. I'm going to slightly contour my nose using a Morphe M330 brush and the Abby color from the Juvia's Place Sahara and Blush Palette Volume 2. I'm going to be sweeping that color all the way up into my brows. That creates a really natural contour for the nose, really natural. I'm just going to be dragging that color down the sides of my nose as well. I'm going to be sharpening up my contour a little bit more using a beauty blender and the Fenty Beauty Banana Powder. I'm going to be placing this down the sides of my nose as well as underneath my cheekbones. And I'm just going to go ahead and dust that powder off right away. We're not trying to bake, we're just trying to add a little bit of reverse contouring to our look. To set my makeup and add a little bit of dewiness, I'm going to be going in with the Makeup Revolution Hyaluronic Hydrating Plumping Makeup Fix and Spray. Good Lord, that is a mouthful. To line my lips, I'm going to be going in with the Jordana Lip Liner in the color Mulberry Cream, and I'm just going to be filling it a little bit more on my top lip just to add a little bit more darkness there. For my lip color, I'm going to be going in with the Maybelline lipstick in the color Almond Rose, and then topping that off with a generic lip gloss from the Beauty Supply Store. And that, my love, completes this look. I really hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe if you are not subscribed already, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified every time I upload. Thank you all so much for being here with me. For my old subscribers and my new subscribers, I really appreciate your support. So for those of you guys that are curious as to why I took such a long hiatus from YouTube, basically I got pregnant. It was wonderful, and I gave birth to a beautiful baby girl, and I'm so incredibly blessed to have three lovely children. And I've just been taking time to spend with my family and figure out how I'm going to navigate being a mom, being a content creator, and pursuing my creative aspirations and my creative goals. And you know, for a while you tell yourself, oh, I'm too busy, I'm too stressed, I have too much on my plate. But ultimately, you have to create the space for the things that you want to do. And I'm finally in a place where I feel like I can do that, where I feel like I want to do that.